What's up, guys? So I was gonna do a little live stream for you because it's Friday and I have nothing else better to do. I'm gonna go refill my DN spreader and once I get him going, I'll probably go back to tillage. We'll spend a good amount of time on tillage. You have to watch out for cars now. I added a spline on this side of the map for vehicles. As you can see, there's one right there. I'm still really not too happy why they changed their car spline system, because if you hit a car, it doesn't like nudge out of the way like it did in 13. It is like a tank. It does not move. Anyways, we have finished our alfalfa. I basically just wanted to test out my T7, and it works pretty well as a front-end loader. I'm a lot heavier than the T6, so don't need a weight or anything like that. Plus, I can put dual rear tires on the back that are buyable, and that can help as a weight and help to stabilize. So we leased a couple of new fields this season. We released field 8, 9, 16, 34, or 35, and 36. So we went from 1,300 or like 1,200, yeah, 13 to about 1,700 acres. I think last time I checked, I'd have to double check that. Tacked on a lot more acres. So we're pretty heavy. We got 36,000 liters of liquid fertilizer, but it's really all I have to refill my DN spreader. So we'll just work our way over here. Finally getting over to this side of the tracks. And we have 30, 31, and 32 left to go. This spline has too many vehicles, I think. Here comes the train, too. Back the truck in here, and I'm sure my driver will go around. I actually watched a documentary on trains the other day, like History of the Railroad. Interesting stuff. So we're gonna come over here and fill up with probably MPK. Because we're in field 8, reference the sheet, and I have it down as MPK. The rented deers finished up 19, I have them sitting over in 37. Which is soybean stubble. We put down NPK, PK, and lime in that field. So you can see the grass is getting crumbled to its first growth stage, not actually being destroyed. And that's one of the benefits of using the wheel lane script. So this guy's gonna go and knock out 8 and 9 and whatever else. Meanwhile, then we got our mowers and baler and everything parked away and clean. So here is big deers. Well, this guy goes on the other side. This guy load up this one. And then we'll get all this information and stuff out of the way. See the 9RT is dusty and 2730 is dirty. Chiseling in this soybean stubble and residue, and then all the nutrients that we broadcasted in lime as well. I don't know what camera angles you guys like better. I personally like the tool cam because it's a little bit narrower field of view. It's set at 38, I believe, instead of like 67 or whatever I have my. We got this one, we got indoor view. We got this view. It's a little bit. I think this one's the best. It's such a big disc. Total bale count on alfalfa was 92, but that's also because I dropped the yield down a little bit. But that's still a pretty good haul for alfalfa. It's a 54-acre field. This guy. It's a nice view too. lot of money in this field right now. You guys are probably like asking, like, oh my god, he's uploading so many videos. It's like, well, some of these videos are a couple days old, you know, and it takes so long. Some of these videos take like 10 hours to upload, and then they only get released once I publish them, so. Like a week and a half worth of videos being uploaded all at once. That's sweet. So this is a virgin field that it's going to be our first season leasing this. kind of out in the middle of nowhere here on the east side of the map. Just big squarish flat fields. Not a whole lot going on. See that bunch of corn residue underneath the grass, and then field 9 and 16 over there are soybean residue, and then 36 is a big grass field. If I pan out enough, you can see 36 is the grass, and then 35 is like a withered field of wheat. So you can kind of see, besides these three fields right here, which is 30, 31, and 32, we're pretty much farming three quarters of the map. Definitely this whole southern part now, and basically this whole east side. There you can see the dairy farm. It's where you do all your dairy cows, and then over there, you can't see it, it's too far away, but that's the beef, modern beef farm. But a lot of these fields over here, this is mostly going to be sunflower. It's going to be a lot of sunflower, and then a lot of these fields over here are going to be milo. So we're planting a lot of milo and sunflower in all these fields over here, and then corn's going to be on the far west, and then the middle fields probably it's going to be soybean again. So we're planting a lot of sunflower and milo, so it should be interesting. Sunflower turned out to be very good year on our sunflower fields. We took really good care of them. Soybean was also really good, and then corn, for whatever reason, corn got neglected in a couple fields. So we're gonna be plowing up field 20, which is our cash cow essentially of alfalfa. And you can see the darker fields there over by the farm, and the 344 and 18, those are going to be our new alfalfa fields. It's like 160 acres of alfalfa, so we're going from 54 acres to 160. So pretty large jump in alfalfa there, but it's going to be nice to have that cash flow. see 19's already finished being plowed. And then our guy is around here somewhere. He's coming back. Anyways, so then we have to go find our John Deere guys. So if I exit and pan out here, you can see the Lake Holmes, see the Hercules, and these guys are just hammering away. You can see soybean residue, chop straw for it, and then we got a little bit of PK lime and NPK in the field. We're incorporating into the soil. So then those three fields will probably be next season. I'm planning on having enough money from selling our grain to pay off my loans that I could take out an even bigger loan. Instead of leasing these fields, I can actually buy them. You see these guys are slowly but surely covering ground. It's nice to have two of them going. I used to run three chisel plows, like 2720s. I used to have three of those in the field. Way back when. About the time when Rafael released his STX tractors. It was when I was kind of doing course play. Added a different window tint to the tractors as well. Gotta love the particle animations in 15. So cool.